Hi, I'm Chris Wardlaw with Auto by Tell, and today we're driving the 2014 Acura RLX, a new flagship sedan for Honda's luxury division. Now, Acura's always had a flagship sedan since its inception in 1986. First it was called the Legend, then it was called the 3.5 RL, which got replaced by the RL, which is now replaced by the RLX. Now, the RLX starts at under $50,000, but it doesn't include navigation. That's the first of four stair-step option packages. The others are the technology package, the Corel audio package, and the advanced package. My test car here's got the advanced package. It's priced at just over $61,000. Let's find out if it's got what it takes to go up against other mid-size luxury sedans. Now, in my opinion, the RLX looks better in person than it does in pictures. Still, this is a very conservatively styled car with a lot of anonymous lines. The most distinguishing features, the signature Acura face, this standard LED headlight array, and this character line that's stamped into the front fender just before the front doors. It's an unusual drop line here to give the profile a little bit of character. Now, these 19-inch wheels are designed to reduce noise as the car is driving, and they're standard with most of the RLX's option packages. And around back, you've got standard LED taillights, which, depending on the day, remind me either of a Chevy Cruze or a BMW 7 Series. Either way, they're not terribly original. Now, the engine does require premium fuel, but it does have variable cylinder management technology, which means half the engine cylinders are shut down when you're just cruising on the highway. That helps bump fuel economy up. In fact, this car is rated to get 31 miles per gallon on the highway, 24 miles per gallon in combined driving. Now, I got 21.5 during my week, but I fed the car a steady diet of city driving, so it's kind of expected that it would get lower fuel economy. Later on in the year, this car will be available with Acura's new Sport Hybrid Super Handling All-Wheel Drive System, a gas-electric hybrid powertrain designed to maximize performance at the same time it maximizes gas mileage. Now, if you want to access the RLX's 15 cubic foot trunk, you can use the release that's on the key fob itself or the touchpad that's located underneath. Now, this isn't a real generous trunk, but 15 cubic feet is enough for four people for a long weekend or even a one-week road trip. What this car could really use, though, is some kind of a power closing mechanism. All Acura gives you is this little grip right here to close the trunk. There's no fancy wave the foot under the bumper action. There's no power trunk closer here. There's no button here, even on this, the top of the line advanced package. And sometimes, I got lucky that time, but sometimes I don't get it closed on the first try. Now, one way that Acura is trying to differentiate itself from other luxury automakers is it's offering more technology in its cars, or at least it's saying that it is. That's why I think it's a little weird that navigation is an option and not standard on a car that costs almost 50 grand. Now, aside from that, this car does have a decent load of standard and optional equipment. I mean, for example, you can get three different audio systems on this car. You can get lane departure warning, lane keeping assist, blind spot information, front and rear parking sensors. There's a laundry list of available features that are related to safety systems and infotainment. Now, most of that stuff works just fine. Most of it's probably not necessary. If you need it, maybe you should rethink having a driver's license. But the thing that bothered me the most about this particular car was the lane departure warning system. It doesn't seem to recognize all lane markings. Sometimes it delivers false alerts when you're not even close to wandering out of a lane. Eventually you end up tuning it out. And thankfully, in this car, you can actually shut it off. All right, so we are underway in the new RLX, and this is a very comfortable and quiet car. The higher option packages include acoustic side glass, which cuts down on road noise at higher speeds. And the 19-inch wheels that come on most option packages are also designed to reduce noise. I think it's very effective. Even when I was driving down Pacific Coast Highway on a very windy afternoon, I only heard a hint of wind noise coming from the seals here on the side of the doors. Now, this 3.5-liter V6 engine is powerful, fuel-efficient, and refined, and the six-speed automatic transmission rarely gets a shift wrong. In fact, the whole time I was driving it, I didn't complain one bit. There's a sport mode that you can press to make the car feel a little bit more responsive. And as you can hear, maybe you can't, I don't know, I can hear it. It sounds great when it's revved. The brakes are excellent. On a hot day, driving in the mountains, they proved fade free. There's plenty of power when you need it, and if you just want to bleed a little pressure on and off, the pedal is very easy to use, feels great underfoot. Ride and handling. Handling is actually pretty good with this car. Even though it's front-wheel drive and carries a lot of weight over its nose, that precision all-wheel steer system does a really good job of getting the car around corners crisply and in an entertaining fashion. The 19-inch wheels grip the road well. No tire squeal from the Michelins on this particular test car. And the suspension is tuned to control roll, dive, and squat quite well. This car feels very athletic. Now the problem with that, to some degree, is the ride quality. And I don't know how to explain it any more than to say that sometimes this is a really bouncy car. Like, you may have seen a lowrider cruising down the street full of guys, and the guys are all in there going like this. Well, that's sometimes what this car feels like. It's typically over higher speed dips, or when you're going through an intersection over a road crown, or you're going over a bridge where there are expansion joints. And I think Acura needs to do a little bit better job of taming that. You know, I like the Acura RLX a lot more than I thought I would. It's like a big, comfortable, luxurious, cushy Honda Accord. And that right there is part of its problem. A Honda Accord doesn't have the power to unseat aspirational leaders in the mid-luxury sedan class like the BMW 5 Series and the Mercedes-Benz E-Class. I mean, people buy cars like this to broadcast success and wealth to the world. And it's not as dynamic to drive as things like the A6 or the Infiniti Q70 or even the new Lexus GS. In fact, I think for me personally, I'd be just as happy with the loaded Honda Accord Touring or even a maxed out Chrysler 300, leaving me with a big chunk of change in my pocket to go out and travel the world with my family and make new memories. For Autobytel, I'm Chris Wardlaw, and I'll see you around the next bend in the road.